All right, this is the solution to problem 15.7. If I had to state which one of the problems on this chapter is going to most closely mirror your final exam, it's this problem right here. We have three options. The first option is fixed rent of $11,000 a month due at the beginning of each month. The second one is variable rent of 5% of sales due at the end of each month. And then finally, we have a hybrid of the two, which is fixed rent of $5,500 per month due at the beginning of each month, and then 2.5% of sales due at the end of each year, not at the end of each month. Then we have our annual sales below that, starting with $2.2 million and going down to $3.4 million if you have your text open. First thing we need to do is just work through our formulas and for the first alternative, and that's 11,000 plus 11,000 times PVA for 11 years and 1%. When we do the math, we're going to actually go ahead and multiply the 11,000 times PVA for 11 periods at 1%, and then add the 11,000. And then for the following years, we need to discount those forward. So we have the same exact formula for year 1 through year 5 for the rent during the year. And then we need to discount it using the PV for 1 year at 12% on year 2. 2 years at 12% on year 3, going down to 4 years at 12% on year 5. As I said, the largest or the greatest challenge that students have with calculating this is they don't do their math right. So I'm just going to walk through the math on a couple of these, and hopefully you'll get the answer of $504,851. If you do 11,000 times 10.3676 plus 11,000, and then when you get that answer, you add it to the answers of 2 through 5. On year 2, you're going to take 11,000 times 10.3676, and you're going to add 11,000 to it, and then multiply it by 0.8929. Going on down to year 5, again, you're going to take the 11,000 times 10.3676 plus 11,000. So you should have the same answer for your first part of the problem, and then you're going to discount that by 0.6355, which is the PV for 4 years at 12%. So our first option is $504,851. The second one, we first need to go ahead and calculate our monthly percentage of sales. So we're going to go ahead and take our annual sales, which is $2.2 million in year one, divide it by 12 and multiply it by 0.05 for the 5%. We're divided by 12 because of 12 months, and we get the percentage of sales paid every month of $91.67 for the year one. For year two, it's $10,000, going down to $14,164. Again, if we look at those numbers, the sales were given to us in the text. We're dividing them by 12 to make them monthly, and then we're multiplying them by 0.05 because of the 5%. So now we've calculated our sales. The next thing we need to do is we need to discount them. We do that by because we don't know our sales until the end of the month, we have to discount all 12 months. So we take the 9167, our monthly rent that we calculated, and multiply it by PVA for 12 periods at 1%. And then on down, we do the same types of calculations we did before, where we go ahead and calculate our monthly rent. We discount our monthly rent for 12 periods at 1%, and then multiply it by the present value for 1 through 4 years for years 2 through 5. When we do the math, we get $103,167 for year 1, and then going down $100,497 for year 2, $100,941 for year 3, $100,142 for year 4, and finally $101,331 for year 5. So the present value of this alternative 2's lease options are $506,087. That is larger than the $504,000 for the fixed rent. So of the two, we would take the fixed rent, but we still need to do alternative 3. On alternative 3, we're going to have to do both. So we're going to do the fixed rent first, and this looks exactly like alternative 1, with the exception of having $5,500 instead of $11,000. And it should be about half, and that's what it is. It's $252,426. So this shouldn't be any surprise to anybody as far as the numbers. Again, the 10.3676 is the present value of 11 period, a present value of annuity of 11 periods at 1%, and the 0.8929 is a PV for 1 year at 12%. Going down to 0.7972, which is PV for 2 years at 12%, 0.7118 is PV for 3 years at 12%, and finally 6355 is the PV for 4 years at 12%. We're going to have to go ahead and calculate our percentage of sales, but we're doing this annually, and it was 2.5% of sales because it's annualized. We don't need to divide it by two. So we take, for the first year, we take our $2.2 million, which was our forecasted sales. Again, the sales came from the textbook. The 0.025 is the 2.5% calculation, and the 0.8929 is discounting it using the present value factor for 1 year at 12%. Going on down, we add these up, we multiply these out, and we add them up, we get $240,888. We add that to our $252,000 in change, and we get $493,305. So the best alternative is actually to go ahead and hold on to the money for the till the end of the year, or hold on to 2.5% of our sales at the end of the year and pay $5,500 a month. And it's significantly lower than the other two alternatives.